Okay, so in this video we're going to be working on removing the crankshaft plugs and counterweights. So as you can see, we have these aluminum caps that are in the main bearing journals, as well as the throws for the connecting rods that are held in with 1/4 inch British standard studs. Nuts on either side. I've already taken out all the split pins, as you can see. Since that was a tedious job that really didn't have any benefit of you watching. And also, if you're going to do any polishing or grinding to the crankshaft, you want to take off these counterweights. Otherwise, you can't get a clean shot at it. And also, in the end, we have a ball bearing that's held in here that also needs to come out. So let's get started. It's important to take these caps out, since if the engine has not had any attention for a while, these areas can be quite full of sludge and even very hard clay-like substance that builds up from centrifugal force. And even if you're sure it's clean in there, you still don't want any debris to go in there from when you're doing any polishing or grinding that can come back and haunt you later and ruin a main bearing or a rod bearing. So I'm gonna put the plug on the stand. Well, I'm gonna start with the number one. See if I can get a good camera angle here. Start with the number one cap here. All right. So we're going to undo the nut. This is going to be one of the harder ones to do, and you'll see why. The big screw end on the end is turning, so I need to get a screwdriver or something to separate that from turning. So that's what that piece looks like. It goes down the middle in there, and you can see it has a screw head on it. Here's the castellated nut. Goes into our container. So we're going to have to put something in there to poke that out. I'm going to get a 1/4 inch extension in there. And yep. And there is the aluminum cap. We do see that there's some. This is a rather small amount because this engine has been rebuilt not terribly long ago. But you can see that there's stuff in there that isn't going to help matters. If you
you left it in there. So now we're going to do the first throw. Sometimes just putting a punch in there and wiggling it around like such will work the cap out. Oh, see, now we have some debris on there. I'll put that aside for a picture. And some sludge. It's not terrible, but still, it's not helping anything with your engine. See, Mike. Okay. Now let's get this next one out. Something that's pretty handy is a quarter inch drive ratchets that have quarter British standard sockets on them. And even though this is a small quarter inch drive size ratchet, it has a 3/8 drive square, so you can put a 3/8 drive socket on. Which is handy. It might seem like a task that another trick is getting this first plug out first. It makes it possible to slide the stud into that area to get it out. Okay. so while I think about what to use, I'm going to move on to the throw here.
Let's see if we got a good angle. Maybe I'd be better off. Or maybe even like this. Yeah, it's not bad. Okay. So, this throw. Number two throw. You don't really have to keep track of where each plug came necessarily. So they don't need to be numbered or anything like that. Now we'll get the next stud and nut for this journal. This might maybe I'll just get the adjacent stud out as well.
This is when it's not. I'm gonna some debris on there. See, I'm getting some sludge on there. So we're cooking along there. Give you a sample of some sludge. Got this guy here. This one, the very center main bearing, is a little bit wider than the other intermediate ones. So it's going to be a longer stud. You can kind of use the stud to wiggle it out.
The pulling place is packed. They are three wide in the parking lot, and they are parked all down the road. Right in the house. Like they're required to track that, and you're, you know, how many many students you have English as a second language, and basically the cost of this program is like an additional teacher. And he says, is that a mandate by the state? Because if it is, that's just another way of them telling us how we have to spend our money. Are we educating illegal immigrants? And Mrs. also said, every child deserves an education. And Brian Bliss did say, you have to realize we have students in this country, and they can't speak the language, you know? I mean, he said we have a lot of adoptions.
Yeah.
I guess he thought he was going to try to make a point.
Hmm. Here we got this. Number 5 throw. A little closer here, maybe. throw. Maybe we'll get from this angle. This and not off of this and we'll hold here. And that is tight. Oof. Still have this cap in here. I'll see if I can work it out. Enough to this in there. All right. Okay, so now the last, one of the last things for the crankshaft plugs is taking out this guy. So, looking for a tab washer. There's one right in there. So we gotta flatten that out. Looks like only one finger is down. I don't have the tool handy for removing this. I want to see if it at least break loose
this method. I kind of suspected it wasn't going to be terribly tight. And when we go back together, I'll use the proper tool. Okay. Tight spot. Tab washer sort of rotates around and catches an edge. And I'll show you what this looks like. Lock tab washer still in place. So I'll have to work that off as I'm cleaning things and sorting. Then we got this bearing. I might need to use a different bearing puller to get that guy. Yeah, I don't think I have a... Well, maybe I do.
Just want to talk about dinner, and then you can go right back.